You know, the first Johad I completed in a 4 year. But in next year, 36 Johad in a 1 year completed. Next year, more than 200. So now I can say today, more than 11,000 Johad completed in this region. 8,600 square kilometer area within the 1,200 communities.
Altermonde.
I came from India in the desert area of the world, a very lowest rainfall in the world in my area. So without water, that time the pupil is displaced. Just some old pupil and children living in the village. The all young people migrate to the cities for the bread, for the life, because without water they can't survive there. When I reach there, that region is displaced. And I'm a traditional mediciner, so I start the treatment of the old pupil. After 6 months, when the cure of the old man, old pupil there, so they say, we not need the medicine and education, we need water. If water is here, we can survive here. Without water, we can't survive here. The Johad is a very old, traditional water harvesting and conservation structures. Is a real system for the water, drinking water, agriculture, animal, and for life, the all aspect covered with the water harvesting structure called Johad. And the, all over the India, these type of the structure we have, from the Kanyakumari to Kashmir, Goa to Guwahati, the all side of the my country, this type of the water bodies we have. But you know, more than 100 years before, we forget this system. And the British government not in the propagate that indigenous law knowledge system about the water management. Due to this new era of development, the greedy development, the extraction technology and the exploitation of the technology, water resource come. And that technology taking just the deposit of the underground aquifer. And that underground aquifer is overdraft. That aquifer is empty. When you give the new aspect of water, the demand and supply, and you can say the privatization of water. When you start the privatization of the water, so people disconnect. You change the ownership of the water. Before, the Johad is the everywhere. And the Johad is a common property related with the poorest of the poor and related with the rich to rich. The everyone have the equal right on that water body. That water body is not of the richer people. That water body is the poorest of the poor. They have the equal right. I start this work in 1985. First 4 years is really difficult because no pupil, no young pupil there. That time I am alone. I am doing my spread and I am doing more than 12 hours every day, the hard work. When the water come in 1988, the good rains come and my first work is completed, and that rain ran catch in this Johad in, and that water going in the underground aquifer, and the pupil can see the water in the wells. So the villagers call the all young people back to the villages. They come back in the villages and they start the agriculture, animal husbandry, and they start the life again. So that displaced village automatically rehabilitated their own without any support of the government and without any support of the corporate. You know, the first Johad I completed in a 4 year, but in next year 36 Johad in a 1 year completed. Next year more than 200. So now I can say today more than 11,000 Johad completed in this region. 8,600 square kilometer area within the 1,200 communities, they automatically rehabilitate. And 8,600 square kilometer area green, they are enjoying the life with water. They give the respect to the water, and water gives the love and affection and prosperity to the people. So why I get success? Why I get success in 1,200 community we join? Because we have no vested interest. I create the 11,000 water bodies, but I am not a owner of any single water body. I am not a owner of the single water body. The owner of the all water body is the communities. So when the community empowerment, skill development, and faith and trust and confidence built, so the people join. The Johad is an ideal model of the community-driven decentralized water resource management. This simple technology, simple engineering, simple science. This science is a common sense science. This is not a commercial science. This is not a calculative or equation-based science. This is a science of the common pupil and common sense. So we join the common sense with common pupil.